Hello everyone. Warm greetings from Janssen's Institute of Technology Coimbatore, which is the preferred destination for holistic learning. The computer was born to solve problems that did not exist before. Quite interesting, isn't it? With this interesting quote from the legend Bill Gates, let's start a session. On behalf of the Computer Science and Engineering Department, we welcome you all for a short session which drags you to the world of computer science and computers. Let's all stay safe in home and keep learning. Computer science and technology rules the world in almost every field and in every walk of our life. You all agree? Of course we should. Simply to say, computer science is an automated visualized technology to replace all manually recorded tasks. Why computer science and what is computer science? We'll have a basic idea by watching a short video about computer science. You all wonder what's computer science? Maybe like the science which we all know, like molecules, atoms, etc. Really what it deals with, we'll see. It is actually an undefined behavior. We need to predict it exactly. Is computer science only about studying computers? We may all have a thought like this, but no. Simply stating computer science is only about computers is like saying that doctor is only related to a stethoscope. Is that okay? Computer science became familiar long ago, before modern computers. In fact, a few decades ago, it has its roots from the olden era. We can add from the abacus age, even before 17th century itself. People describe all calculations manually, that is, they are the human computers in all professions, and all manipulated things were using their hands and brains. In those days, women were human computers and few became programmers also. From basic operations, they involved even critical operations like analyzing the feasibility power of a hydrogen bomb itself. So, think of the power. Simply, a science depends on observation of real-world activities or procedures, and it follows a scientific method for obtaining results. So, likewise, we can't say that computer science is merely computers. And also we can't say that it's merely a simple science. It's all about data and processing the data. In other words, it's about how to solve problems faster and in an efficient manner without much manual work, that is, without much human interruption. For example, we can see an interesting scenario about a Super Mario computer game. Always games are interesting, right? So, we'll see about this. Look at the Mario, how he's running and jumping. So, if he runs faster, he'll touch the flagpole. But before that, obstacles on the way. Let's have an interesting question here. Maybe, which level is best or which level is easier? And which path is easy to move, and so on. And with respect to the path, you can see two pathways. One at the top of the brick and the next one reaching that obstacle. On this, we can have few more doubts and questions also. That is, do these moves win? And next one, is this level even beatable? Suppose someone tells a better way to reach the pole easily, listen to them carefully and try their method, which may delight us in winning. And also if it is wrong, then that's all, the game is over. So, it's a dumb way of believing and trying all the possible ways. Shall we think of completing it faster and winning the game always? It is not. But actually, this question is one of the hardest in the math problems in the current research. That is nothing but polynomial versus non-deterministic polynomial. No solution for it, and it is actually difficult to solve. It is a simple P versus NP problem. Even scientists researchers are doing this. $1 million are given for solving this particular problem. But here, we doesn't care for Mario, because Mario is a simple character and it's just a game, right? But if instead of a simple game, which we all play, assume that it's between a hacker and a bank account, you believe everyone's methods and try all their techniques? No, there comes the use of computation with the help of a computer. So we believe on encryption techniques, which relies on the idea of prime numbers. Breaking a number into prime factors is really hard to crack. So now, with this idea, shall we see whether Mario is beatable in a faster time? We can see how much possible ways a problem is being connected and how many ways a problem can be solved and how many possible pathways are there which leads Mario to the solution. How can a Mario travel, different paths and its combinations and so on, and finally how he completes the game. So now, coming back to computer science, it is just starting from a simple computing device abacus to calculators, computers, desktops, laptops, etc. Every time it improves in its technology with more computations and much faster. Computer science is sequencing the genome science also, where DNA is analyzed and human body is understood well using computations. And also all realistic effects are visualized in brand new virtual reality techniques. Access to technology is in our fingertips nowadays. It brings us closer to a long-lasting friend who is far away, or some technology which is developed somewhere in the world. It's a platform to share ideas, to learn, to implement, and to analyze in all types of professions. From framing ideas to developing cognitive machines, it is possible nowadays. It paves way for the future ideas and future world. It's developing to the next frontier always, and surely one day we'll be reaching there. And all these are happening only because of the advancements in computer science research field, which are really unimaginable. That's the power of computer science field and the usage of computers. Hope you all had a glimpse of computer science field and its purpose. Now, to evolve in this field, we need to have a machine or a device or some triggering notion. For example, to operate a TV, we use a remote or a TV button. Similarly, we need a device named computer or tablet or a mobile or server, etc. in computer science field. Whatever the invention, there are evolutions and updations every moment. Like we learning the history of our nation, or like we knowing the evolution of our family, we'll also gather knowledge on the evolution of computers. So let's see about the evolution of computers now. Hello guys, hope you all are aware of the computer evolution from its ancient time. It's really a great challenge the engineers or researchers face to evolve in our current technology where we all get whatever we need in a single button click. Computers are incredibly fast, accurate, but it is really stupid. Humans are incredibly slow, inaccurate, but we are really brilliant. So together, computers and humans are more powerful than our imagination. So, shall we see a video clipping on computers? Today, computers are used everywhere, ranging from a desktop computer to smartphones. They are changing our lifestyle to a great extent, which is unimaginable. Computer is being used by everyone in all the fields, starting from a kid for learning to teachers, doctors, researchers, and so on. They use in various modes, that is, either by use of a simple desktop, laptop, tablet, notebook, server, etc., depending on their purpose of usage and their application. But we have never inquired ourselves what exactly the computer is. Is it a simple non-living thing, or a machine, or instrument, or a device, or what exactly it is? A computer is an electronic device that manipulates information or data. The computer sees data as a combination of zeros and ones. These two inputs are called bits, and the entire number system uses a combination of these two bits alone to process whatever data we give. But it knows how to combine them in a more complex thing, such as a document, a photograph, a movie, a website, a game, and much more. Computer uses a combination of hardware and a software for its efficient working. Hardware is any physical part of the computer, which includes all of the internal components and also the internal and external parts like the monitor, keyboard, etc. Software is any certain instruction that tells the hardware what to do. It is a program which is given and executed for any application, such as a web browser, a media player, a word processor, a paint drawing, or a video rendering, etc. Whatever application we use, it is done by a programmable software. Now, most of us use computers, mostly a personal computer. This could be a desktop model or a laptop computer, which has basically the same capabilities but in a portable package with few more advanced features. Each type has its own capabilities and advantages depending on their usage. Personal computers, which we use normally, come in two main styles, a PC and a Mac. A PC is also called as an IBM compatible machine. These computers are customizable. PCs are the most common type, and there are many different companies manufacturing them, and they usually come with Microsoft Windows operating system. We could also use Linux and Unix operating system in any PC. Mac is a Macintosh computer, all made by one company, Apple, and they come with Mac OS. They are capable of running all operating systems and can be run side by side. These computers are not customizable. Computers come in many other shapes and sizes. That is, it can be a mobile phone, a tablet, and even TVs have a built-in computer. There is another type of computer that plays an important role in our life, but very few are aware of those type of computers, that is, servers. Servers serves an information to other computers on a network. In fact, every time we use the internet, web servers available somewhere delivers the web pages we need to see in our computer. It needs to be connected in any network to say LAN or WAN, that is a local area network or a wide area network, etc. Several servers are used in and around us. To name a few, a mail server is used for transferring mails.
File server, as the name says, it is used for transferring files, etc. Servers are also used in many offices to store and share files. Any computer can act as a server. And for business purposes, rack-mountable servers are used where information can be shared in parallel to multiple systems. It is important that hardware support for the server's preparation. As we can see, there are many different types of computers serving to our lifetime in several ways.
As we all have seen the basics of computers, how a computer stores data in terms of zeros and ones, and how a particular server is helpful for us, and what are the types of devices. Now we can see how an information is converted to a valid data, and how data is stored in a computer using memory storage devices.
We can now see how information is processed in a computer. Computer accepts inputs, that is data. The input is translated into binary numbers and processed. It also produces output, that is a valid information. Input is in terms of zeros and ones. It is getting processed, that is a particular software program is getting executed here based on the instructions given by the programmer, and it is compiled and executed, and accordingly it produces an output for the user's application. Thus, computers processes a simple input and gives an output. We can see the components of a computer. It consists of two main parts. As we have seen, it is hardware versus software. A hardware component deals with internal and external components. That is, it is made up of a system unit, keyboard, monitor, mouse, printer, modem, multimedia devices, etc. We can see in the diagram that an input device will be sending some inputs to the central processing unit, and central processing unit sends some output to the output device. Here, the input device can be as simple as a keyboard or a mouse or a microphone, and an output device can be as simple as a monitor or a speaker, etc. Central processing unit is the heart of the computer. Here we have a control unit and arithmetical logical unit, and this control and arithmetic logic unit processes input, and it uses the memory unit for its storage purpose. It can store the value in the memory, and it can retrieve in future for its processing, and it can delete the memory which it has used also. So after processing, that is once the software gives some instruction, it processes using control and arithmetic logic unit, and it proceeds with the output to the output device. This is the overall view of the components of a computer. Now we'll see about a processor. It does the calculations, and speed is a very important factor which is measured in megahertz. The faster the processor, the more calculations performed per second. And next is random access memory, that is RAM. It is used as a working area for the computer. It holds the working program, data being used, and also the results. It is volatile and stores temporary information. And hard disk is the permanent memory which records and stores all programs and data or information magnetically. And next we can see about a few examples of input devices. You can see the mouse, keyboard, joystick, web camera, stylus, barcoder, everything comes under input device. And to name a few output devices, we can see web camera, microphone, printer, monitor, speakers, etc. Few examples. Now, you all visualized about the basic computer parts and its processing. Also, we saw about the types of computers and various basic storage methods. Now, on having knowledge about computer science field, computer evolution, and computer processing, we'll see about the application of computers. As you have completed just your higher education, you all will be familiar in concepts of physics, chemistry, and maths alone. And few will be aware of computer science, and other few will be aware of biology. So we'll see how physics, chemistry, or mathematics is applied successfully using computers. Shall we see an interesting example? Everyone likes gaming, and that too animated gaming using computers. So here we see how a basic physics is implemented in a computer game. That is Angry Birds game. Hope you all know about that. The basic idea is that we launch these birds with a slingshot, and the birds are very angry. The goal is to knock over some pigs. Why can't we just play the dumb game and move on? No, since it is a computer game and we as professionals, we need to know the science behind that computer game. In this computer game, is there physics? Yes, there is absolutely physics behind this computer game. Whatever you have learned as basics in school is applied everywhere with the help of computers. You can check the game in this angle. The birds simply travel, or do the birds have a constant vertical acceleration? Do they simply travel, or do they have a constant horizontal velocity? And do they simply travel, or do they have an angle for which they move? And is there any fixed length for the sling, etc.? All the questions can be raised in terms of physics. Here is the plot of the horizontal position of the bird as a function of time. As you can see, it emerges in the higher position. And what is a scale? Just consider an object that should be in each level, that is the slingshot. And the length of the slingshot be something, let it be AB. What does this mean? This means that the bird was moving at a constant velocity in the direction X. This is real physics and real projectile motion. In that case, this would be a force diagram for the bird in the air. Very similarly, there is a velocity and acceleration logic behind the bird's movements in developing this game. Hope you are interested to know the basic science or mathematical logic behind everything in computers. And of course, everything which is manually computed or worked out can be converted to automation through computer science. That's the importance of computer science and engineering. None other profession is involved in every field and everywhere. But in this technology era, computers assist all the professionals. Computers play a vital role in medical field, gaming, entertainment, science, research, agriculture, etc., to name a few. You know how chemistry is used in computers? Yes. Even for the current pandemic, COVID-19, researchers use computers and technology only to predict the movement, speed, and structure of coronavirus. World Economic Forum researchers want to use our computers in the search for a COVID-19 vaccine. The project focuses on what's called the spike protein, which triggers the COVID-19 infection. This spike constantly changes shape as the proteins within its fold and unfold. And analyzing this means studying all the potential shapes it could take through this process using computers. Predicting and modeling the vast number of possible permutations of this virus calls for a lot of computer power. Here, the molecular structure is analyzed using artificial intelligence, distributed computers, networking, image processing, and so on. Here, doctors use the computers and technology to save our lives in analysis, prediction, determination of virus structure and vaccine, etc. So we need skilled researchers and engineers. Hope you gathered the need and importance of computer science engineering and as well as engineers. Without engineers, there are no machines which we use now in our daily life. We saw about two simple applications. We'll also watch a short video to know about few other applications of computers in various fields. We all started our session with the statement that computer science and technology rules the world. In order to prove that statement, we can now see a few emerging technology innovations which are developed and which we are gonna use in our near future. So hope you are excited to know our future. Yes, let's start our future journey with computers and technology innovations. Google Glass, it produces a feel of ubiquitous computing which has an integral 5 megapixel video camera. It displays information in a smartphone-like hands-free format, whereas communicated with the internet through natural language commands. Next is Leap Motion, which is a software designed for hand tracking in virtual reality. It is a computer hardware sensor device that supports hand and finger motions as input, very similar to a mouse, but requires no hand contact or touching. The IR lights are used through camera and it is solved using complex maths. A 3D printing or additive manufacturing is a process of making three-dimensional solid objects from a digital file. It enables you to produce complex shapes. Next is transparent phone. We have seen only in countless science fiction movies. It allows a device to turn transparent when an electric current is passed through it. Flexible technology has been adapted and used to mold and generally to be unbreakable, making it very appealing to use. We can even fold, we can even turn, rotate, but it doesn't break, whatever it may be. These allow us to get a real idea of how quickly a software vendor can achieve what they said they would. Next is flying car technology. It is a car of personal air vehicle or roadable aircraft that provides door-to-door transportation by both ground and air. The term flying car is also sometimes used to include hover cars. Many prototypes have been built since the first year of 20th century using a variety of flight technologies, and some have true VTOL performance, but no flying car has yet reached production status. The next technology is Internet of Things, which is a cloud platform. IoT has begun to ramp up at a much greater pace, which has already changed the way we live. For example, we are already seeing the transformation of products to products or services. For example, connected homes and industrial machinery, appliances, etc. Given its projected growth, we are on the cusp of what looks to be an IoT tsunami. Even we can visualize how a person wakes up and proceeds his activities with a single touch, even with a TV or be it a car or be it a cup and saucer, etc. Simply put, a smart sensor is a device that takes input from the physical environment available at present and uses the built-in computing resources to perform functions when they detect specific input and then process accordingly with the data before passing it on. We can also visualize a health IoT application where a woman choosing her costumes available in her wardrobe using a single screen using IoP and applying cosmetics and making her presentable and also tries various options all by using a single click and also checking finally with the smart selfie too. You can also see how a person who is a manager in a company allows a new friend inside his office through a click without the interruption of a security guard. Everything is made in a single click, which is possible only with the help of an IoT. You can also see how a fitness freak wins her calorie count using an IoT device. Hope you all guys enjoyed the session regarding computers, starting from computer science domain, followed by the evolution of computers, then components of a computer and its applications. Finally, to know our future, we also saw about emerging technology trends in the computer science field. On behalf of Janssen's Institute of Technology, I once again thank you all for your participation. We all meet you soon in a questionnaire session. Thank you. Happy learning.